Often, the easiest way to tell a data story is to simply compare one given number with another. When we hear 75% of people think this or two-thirds of companies do that, what we are hearing are the results of analyzing a given set of data. And three helpful measures for doing so are proportions, ratios, and rates. All of these measures are easy to calculate, use, and understand. This video will introduce you to the concepts of proportions, ratios, and rates, and the differences between them. This video is intended for viewers who wish to gain a basic understanding of three types of measures: proportions, ratios, and rates. No previous knowledge is required. Although proportions, ratios, and rates are similar to each other, they each have different properties. In this video, you will learn the differences between these three measures. In addition, by the end of this video, you will be able to answer the following questions: how is each one calculated, and when is it best to use one rather than the other? This diagram is a visual representation of the data journey, from collecting the data to exploring, cleaning, describing, and understanding the data, to analyzing the data, and lastly, to communicating with others the story the data tell. In the data journey, the use of proportions, ratios, and rates are part of the explore, clean, and describe step and are also used to analyze and model. Let's start with proportions. A proportion is a part, share, or number considered in comparative relation to a whole. The smallest value for a proportion is 0, while the largest possible value is 1. A proportion can be expressed as a percentage by multiplying its value by 100. Proportions are useful when you want to compare a number to a total. For example, in an audience of 50 people, 5 are left-handed. This can be expressed as a proportion by dividing 5 by 50 for a result of 0.1, or 10% by multiplying 0.1 by 100. Imagine you have a standard deck of 52 playing cards. The deck contains 13 cards of each suit: diamonds, hearts, clubs, and spades. For the sake of this example, we will assume that there are no jokers or any extra cards. What is the proportion of diamonds in the deck? To calculate this proportion, we should first count the number of diamond cards. There are 13. Then, we would divide this number by the total number of cards in the deck, which is 52. This gives us a proportion of 0.25. Expressed as a percentage, the answer is 25%. Now, let's move on to ratios. A ratio tells us the relative size of two values. The difference between a proportion and a ratio is that with ratios, you have more freedom to compare. The notation is also different. While ratios can be expressed as numbers or percentages, they are most commonly expressed with a colon. Placing a colon in between the numbers 2 and 1, for example, should be read as a ratio of 2 to 1. This means that the first value is twice as large as the second value. A ratio of 3 to 2, meanwhile, means that for every 3 of the first item, there are 2 of the second item. A good example of this can be observed if you ever tried to cook rice. Depending on the rice, the instructions might say 2 parts water to 1 part rice. And what that means is that it doesn't matter if you're trying to cook rice for 2 people or 20 people, just knowing the ratio of 2 to 1 water to rice means that whatever volume of rice you have, double it to get the amount of water and you have the right amounts to start cooking. Another difference between proportion and ratio is that in a ratio, you can choose which quantity is used as the reference. Instead of counting 2 parts of water for every part of rice, you could choose to express it as 1 part of rice for every 2 parts of water. It is often easier to express the biggest quantity as a relative size of the smallest, but in some contexts, the alternative can be preferable. Finally, the ratio is often expressed in the simplest terms. A ratio of 4 to 2 is better understood if it is being expressed as 2 to 1. Let's return to our playing card example. What is the ratio of diamonds to hearts? To calculate this ratio, we should first count the number of diamonds. From our previous question, we know that this number is 13. Next, let's count the second part of our ratio, which is the number of hearts. The number of hearts is equal to the number of diamonds, which is again 13. Expressed as a ratio, we have 13 to 13. However, this ratio can be simplified by dividing both sides by the same number. Here, both sides can be divided by 13, which gives us a ratio of 1 to 1. This means that for every diamond card in the deck, there is 1 heart card. Let's see if you can calculate proportions and ratios. First, what proportions of the deck is made up of queens? Pause the video here and restart once you think you have the answer. 4 out of the 52 cards are queens. The proportion of queens in a deck is about 0.08, or 8%. Now, what is the ratio of face cards to non-face cards in the deck? Pause the video now to work it out and restart once you are ready to see the full answer. there are 4 suits, diamonds, spades, clubs, and hearts. In each suit, there are 3 different types of face cards, jacks, queens, and kings, and 10 different types of non-face cards. 4 times 3 is 12, so there are 12 face cards in the deck. 4 times 10 is 40, so there are 40 non-face cards in the deck, meaning the ratio of face cards to non-face cards is 12 to 40. Or more simply, for every 3 face cards, there are 10 non-face cards. Let's move on to rates. The simplest definition of a rate is that it is one quantity divided by another quantity. With that definition, both proportions and ratios could qualify as being rates. So what is the difference between rates and the other two measures? Proportions and ratios are commonly used to compare quantities that have the same unit of measurement. In decks of cards, for example, both quantities that are compared are counts representing number of cards. In a rate, the two quantities that are compared often have different units of measurements. For instance, speed is a rate. It is the distance traveled in kilometers, for instance, divided by the time it took to travel that distance in hours. The rate would have kilometers per hour as a unit of measurement. One type of rate that is practically useful is a growth rate. A growth rate compares the change in a measurement over a period of time to the values of the measurement at the start of the period. It is very useful to assess the change over time. This figure represents the amount of money available in a savings account at the start of the years 2018, 2019, and 2020. Suppose you wanted to evaluate the change in the savings account during the year 2018. What would you do? To calculate the growth rate of the amount of money in your savings account, first, you would calculate the change that occurred during the year. You do this by taking the amount of money saved at the start of 2019, which was $1,200, and subtracting the amount that was in the account at the start of 2018, which was $800. The difference is $400. Then, you divide this difference by the amount in the account at the start of 2018. In this case, this means you would divide $400 by $800. The result is 0.5. This growth rate can then be multiplied by 100 if you want to express it as a percentage. This gives you 50%, meaning during 2018, the amount in your savings account increased by half the value of what it contained at the beginning of the year. Now it's your turn. What was the growth rate of the amount in the savings account during 2019? That is, between January 1st, 2019 and January 1st, 2020. Pause the video now and restart when you are ready to see the full answer. The answer is negative 0.25, or negative 25%. And here's why. First, we took the amount of money in the account at the start of 2020, which was $900, and subtracted that amount from the start of 2019, which was $1,200. This gave us a negative number of minus $300. Then we divide that difference by the amount at the start of 2019, $1,200, which resulted in a growth rate of negative 0.25 or negative 25%. The negative growth rate means that the amount of money in the savings account decreased in 2019. 1/4 or 25% of the initial value was lost during the year. Let's review the 3 measures we've covered. A proportion is a part, share, or number considered in comparative relation to a whole. It can be equal to 0, 1, or any value between 0 and 1. It can be expressed as a number or percentage. One example in official statistics would be the proportion of the Canadian population who lives in a given province. A ratio is the relative size of 2 values. It can be used to compare 2 parts to another. Ratios can be made up of any positive values and are commonly expressed as 2 numbers separated by a colon or by a single number. An example in official statistics is the gender wage ratio, which compares earnings by gender. Finally, a rate is a more general measure in which one quantity is divided by another quantity, where both quantities don't necessarily need to have the same unit of measure. It can be equal to any value including negative numbers. Like proportions, it can be expressed as a number or a percentage. A well-known example is the annual growth rate. In the following slides, we will go through some example of proportions, ratios, and rates from real data. Table 1 presents the demographic estimates in the middle of the year by sex for the years of 2018 and 2020. What proportion of the Canadian population was male in 2019? To find the answer, you would have to divide the number of males, 18.7 million, by the total population, 37.6 million. This gives us our answer. The proportion of males in the Canadian population in mid-2019 was 0.497. Multiplying by 100 will give the answer as a percentage, 49.7%. Now try to calculate the sex ratio, or the ratio of males to females, in the Canadian population in 2019. Pause the video and give it a try now. Looking at this table, we would say that the ratio is 18.7 million males for every 18.9 million females. However, this sounds confusing. There must be a better way to report this information. Instead, let's try to express the ratio as a decimal number by dividing the number of males by the number of females. This gives us an answer of 0.99. In other words, in July 2019, there were 0.99 males for every female in the Canadian population. This would help your audience to understand that there were fewer males than females in the Canadian population. As well, given that this ratio is close to 1, we can conclude that the gap between the number of males and females is small. Finally, let's return to the same table to calculate the growth rate in the Canadian population between 2018 and 2019. First, you would calculate the difference in population between the 2 years, and then divide the difference by the population size in the earlier year, which in this case is 2018. Multiplying this answer by 100 allows us to express this rate as a percentage. Here, we get a growth rate of 1.3%. Since the growth rate is positive, we can conclude that the Canadian population increased from 2018 to 2019. Did you know that rates can also be used to predict the future? We can see in Table 1 that the size of the Canadian population was 38 million in 2020. But if the data were not available yet, how would we be able to predict it from the 2018 and 2019 population estimates? A quick and simple way to do that would be to assume that the growth rate between 2019 and 2020 would be the same as the growth rate between 2018 and 2019. Then, we would apply this rate to the 2019 population to calculate the growth rate and add it to the 2019 population. As we saw earlier, the growth rate between 2018 and 2019 was 1.3%. Multiplying this rate by the 2019 population, 37.6 million, we get 0.5 million. This represents the predicted growth by mid-2020. Then, adding this number to the 2019 population, 37.6 million, we get 38.1 million. How did we do? The result, 38.1, is slightly larger than the real estimate of 38 million. This means that the actual growth rate between 2019 and 2020 ended up being smaller than it was in the previous year. Still, our prediction was very close. Let's recap the key points that we covered in this video. Proportions, ratios, and rates are all useful for comparing numbers and can appear to be quite similar. However, a proportion is a part, share, or number considered in comparative relation to a whole, while a ratio is the relative size of two values. A rate is the quantity that is divided by another quantity, and all three measures have different properties. It is also interesting to note that rates, such as growth rate, can be used in making predictions about the future.